All right. Example 7 is asking us to identify the domain and range of y is equal to ln ln x minus 2. Now, ln is the same as saying log to the base e. So in other words, we're being asked to answer the question, we're going to sketch the graph of the function. So in essence, we're being asked to sketch the graph of a we're being asked to sketch a log graph. Now, essentially, the log graph would look something like this. I'm going to erase this soon. The log graph would look something like this. Now, this would be the graph of y is equal to ln x. The graph of y is equal to ln x would look something like that. Now, the graph of y is equal to ln x minus 2 essentially looks the same way, but the graph is going to get pushed 2 units to the right. So right now, the graph for the graph of y is equal to ln x, the y-axis, which is x is equal to 0, is a vertical asymptote. Now, an asymptote is a straight line that a graph approaches, but it never, ever, ever what touches. So y is equal to, sorry, the y-axis is a vertical asymptote for the graph of y is equal to ln x. Now, the graph of y is equal to ln x minus 2 is the same graph, but it is pushed 2 units to the right. So if the y-axis, which is the y-axis, sorry, which is the line x is equal to 0, is a vertical asymptote, and you push the entire graph 2 units to the right, it means that the vertical asymptote is now going to become the line x is equal to 2. All right, so I'm going to do a sketch of the graph. I'm going to start by drawing my vertical axis. This is the y-axis, which is the line x is equal to 0. This is the x-axis. One, two. All right, let me change the color here. All right, because I just want to highlight. All right, so this is two. Push this over a little. So that's x is equal to 2. This is the line x is equal to 2, 1, 2. And remember, the graph of y is equal to ln x. The y-axis, which is the line x is equal to 0, is a vertical asymptote. But for y is equal to ln x plus minus 2, x is equal to 2 is a vertical asymptote. So my graph is going to look something like this. So this would be a sketch of the graph of y is equal to ln x minus 2. Now, now we need to answer the question about identify the domain and the range. All right, remember, if you imagine that this graph goes on forever in both directions, well, for starters, you can see that the graph does not exist to the left of the line x is equal to 2. The graph does not exist to the left of the line x is equal to 2. So the domain which of y is equal to ln x minus 2. The domain is x is greater than 2. That's the domain. The domain are the values of x where the graph exists. The graph only exists for values of x greater than 2. So the domain values are values of x greater than 2. Now, if you imagine that this graph is going on forever in both directions, you'll see that the range values are the range of y is equal to ln x minus 2. The range is y is an element of the set of real numbers. This graph exists for all values of y, but it only exists for values of x greater than 2. So the domain is x is greater than 2, and the range is y is an element of the set of real numbers. In other words, it is all real numbers. Now, example 8 is asking us to identify the domain and the range of y is equal to e to the minus x plus 2. And of course, doing this question becomes easy if you can if you can do a sketch of the graph or a reasonably accurate sketch of the graph. All right, so let's go. All right, so I'm doing a sketch of this graph. Let me start by drawing my y-axis. I'll talk to you about this graph in a second. So the y-axis, which is the line x is equal to 0. Now, the graph of y is equal to e to the minus x looks something like this. So it's just a sketch. The graph of y is equal to e to the minus x looks something like this. So that's on the right. Y is equal to e to the minus x. It looks something like that. It cuts the y-axis at 1, and the x-axis is a horizontal asymptote. An asymptote is a straight line that the graph approaches, but it never, ever, ever what touches. Now, if you want to draw this graph of y is equal to e to the minus x plus 2, essentially they are the same graph, but you're going to push the graph 2 units up. Now, when we do translation, we'll get into why that is the case. You can probably imagine why that is the case, but to get the graph of y is equal to e to the minus x plus 2 is the graph of y is equal to e to the minus x that has been what? Vertically translated by what? 2 units. You push it up 2 units. So in other words, the x-axis, which is the line y is equal to 0, was the asymptote. But once you push it 2 units up, the line y is equal to 2 is going to become the new asymptote. So let's put in the x-axis. This is the x-axis. Let us say that this is 1 and that this is 2. This is y is equal to 2. Sorry, just trying to change the color. Didn't succeed. All right, this is y is equal to 2. Now, because you push it up 2 units, y is equal to 2 is a new asymptote. It would have cut the graph at 1, but because you push it up 2 units, it's now going to cut the graph at 3, cut the y-axis at 3, and the graph would look something possibly like this. Right. So this would be a sketch of the graph of y is equal to ln, sorry, y is equal to e to the minus x plus 2. Now, from the sketch of the graph, we can determine what is the domain and what is the range. Essentially, the domain are the values of x where the graph exists, and the range would be the values of y where the graph exists. Now, if you imagine this graph going on forever in both directions, you'll notice that the graph basically exists for every value of x. So the domain of y is equal to e to the minus x plus 2 is x is an element of the set of real numbers. In other words, it's all real numbers. Now the range would be the values of y where the graph exists. This is the line y is equal to 2. And it is clear from the sketch that the graph does not exist below the line y is equal to 2. So the graph only exists for values of y greater than 2. So the range of y is equal to e to the minus x plus 2 is y is greater than 2.